I'm Kevin Whitaker. I'm from South Carolina. I grew up on a little farm in a town of 54 people. Saw spirits the entire time that I lived there. Tried to communicate that to my parents, family members, and stuff. And a little hard for them to believe. And plus, you're in the Bible Belt, so that's not real cool. Ended up as a private investigator. And naturally, the two skills kind of go together. Being intuitive, receiving spirit, and then working wrongful death cases and missing persons cases. It just went hand in hand.
Jay was he had a big heart. Family meant everything to him.
Me and Jay met when I was 13 and he was 14 years old. And I was actually scared to meet him because he was known for always being, you know, in trouble and being a bad boy and stuff. And I remember, I'm like, I don't want to meet him. Too scared to, but fell in love with him the first time I laid my eyes on him, so.
He had this tough guy exterior, but he was like a big teddy bear.
I'd like to know what happened that night. Like, I'd like for somebody to tell me what happened to them. Like, will we ever find them again? Will, just something.
This boat catches my interest in that I feel like there should have been a cabin on the boat that they took. I think it's just odd that the paddle boat never turned up either.
Yeah.
But I think I have a theory about that too, that kind of goes along with what I see intuitively. It was strange reliving, for me it's almost like reliving these events. I kept getting the name JR called out. I didn't know how it fit in after kind of seeing the case as far as like maybe a nickname or initials or something of that nature. I kept trying to place the initials. I was a little surprised with what I kept getting visually. My thought is that boat, the Boston Whaler, had been tied to the paddle boat, and the paddle boat was being pulled along by the Boston Whaler. And oddly enough, and I always just voice what I get these red pants that may have already been found by police, not something that we've heard, that may be associated with this and maybe not expected to be, maybe evidence or something of that nature.
My name is Barbara Fleury. My gift comes to me first as a feeling, then it can shift into a knowing. The intuitive side is the gut, your gut instinct. With through that can come your visions or your glimpses and knowings and things like that.
As I got down to the marina, I kept getting a spirit. It's odd because he calls a JR. And I don't know if those initials mean anything.
His name is JR. We call them Jay. We only ever called him JR when we were mad at him.
Hard to say, but I think one fell over by accident. And then when I saw the jumping, I think somebody jumped over to help. And then there's two in trouble, and then they, you know what I mean? They were all trying to help each other.
When I talk about my impressions on that night, I do get kind of a repeated event that obviously kind of spells doom for a bunch of boys. And I have one in the water. My thought is they probably stopped that boat on that choppy water, not really knowing or appreciating what to do out there, and trying to get a friend back to the boat. Another thing that I kept getting, this is going to sound strange, but I keep getting the situation where I feel like these red pants have turned up as evidence somewhere else. And I didn't know if one of these guys had been wearing red jeans. I know it sounds weird, it sounds dated, during that time period, but I keep getting that sense.
about Kevin?
No, I definitely want to go upstairs and get that book and find out what the description was, because the red jeans is...
I honestly believe that's what he was wearing that night.
Think so?
Yep.
I remember from the top, picture. I just can't remember what
from
pants, but yeah, possibly.
My picture that I have.
He did have them. And then the JR thing, just, there's no way he could have known.
No, JR was like, JR.
To take a peek, to find that I was by the sea.